My channel is called Free Plants Forever, which begs the question, free plants, where do you get free plants? So I'm gonna break down to you my top five places where I find free plants. This is gonna come with a disclaimer, of course. Not everyone is going to agree with all of these methods for getting free plants. And every place has different rules, of course. So I always recommend asking. It never harms to ask if you're not sure if you can take a plant or a leaf for free. In my own experience, when I have asked, people have been happy for me to take the plants in question, but I do realize that there does come some privilege with that. So bear that in mind, of course. So let's get into it. My top five places to get free plants. Coming in at number five, and you may roll your eyes at this one, your own garden and your own plant collection. What do I mean by this? How is this free? Well, if you're watching this channel, it is highly likely that you already have plants. And depending on the kind of plants you have, it's very possible that you can propagate those plants to make more plants. This goes not only for asexual propagation, which means using a leaf or a cutting, such as a succulent, where say, for example, I have this succulent, I want to propagate it, I simply twist off a leaf. I've just created a new plant for myself. If I set this succulent leaf on the soil, leave it for a few weeks, it will grow a whole new succulent, free plants, right? This also goes for sexual propagation or reproduction. And by that, of course, I mean seeds. Collecting seeds from your existing plants is a great way to get more free plants. For example, I have a ton of wildflowers in my front yard. They started from seeds that I bought at Home Depot. I shook those seeds out, the wildflowers grew, the season ended. Those wildflowers created so many seeds, and I now have tons of seeds in my collection. I have a whole seed drawer. I've also done it with sweet peas, marigolds, vegetables as well, say beans or pumpkins. Those seeds can be collected, replanted the following year. There are also multitudes of tropical plants or traditional house plants that can be propagated. Ficus, for example, this is my fiddle leaf fig. It's a type of ficus. There's also rubber trees. Those can be cut, the stems can be placed into water, and they will grow roots and they will grow new trees. Similarly, pothos or heartleaf philodendron, vining plants like that, can be so easily propagated by snipping the vines, finding a node, and placing them either in water or another medium such as sphagnum moss or perlite. So yes, it does seem obvious, but your own collection of plants is a great place to start for getting free plants. Coming in at number four, and this is another one that may seem a little bit obvious, but is often overlooked, friends and family. Friends and family is a great resource for getting free plants. And by this, I mean getting cuttings from, say, plants that get overgrown, doing a plant swap similar to cuttings, grabbing some leaves, helping out around the garden and using those cuttings to propagate. So many of my plants came from my mother's garden where she was cutting things back and I took the clippings. I have tons of aloe that came from her yard, so many succulent leaves. And this, of course, is a two-way street. You should also be willing to give clippings or leaves of your plants to your friends and family so that you guys can mutually benefit from this practice. Number three on my list is Facebook Marketplace or Nextdoor. So many people on these sites have yard cuttings or moving sales where they are trying to offload plants and are usually plant lovers as well. For example, my front yard, I have a ton of blue agave Americana. Those things like grow pups like crazy. They are a little bit invasive. There was a woman, she wanted to extend her driveway and she had an agave problem. I came up with my shovel and I got a ton of huge mature agave plants, which are now putting off tons of pups that I don't even know what to do with, and will also probably put those up on Marketplace to give away for free as well. A lot of times people are moving and they have plants they can't take with them. Sometimes people want to be paid for these things, of course, but you can always barter. Sometimes it's just an address. It's like first come, first serve. Hey, I have a box of cuttings on the side of the road. Come and get them. Sometimes they want your help in removing a plant and you can take it if you want. It's really worthwhile going through there, scrolling around, going in the garden section or going in the free section. It's a great way to fill your plant collection with plants that are often very large and mature for little to no money. And one cool thing is these sites often feature plant groups where you can make friendships or just find out where there's other plant swaps and kind of meet like-minded people. And it doesn't have to just be plants. I've gotten a ton of boulders. Sometimes people have lawn furniture. Sometimes it's an estate sale or a garage sale or a moving sale. And you can get rock bottom prices for things that would otherwise have been pretty expensive. Number two on my list is almost more of an attitude, right? Looking and being aware of your surroundings to find free plants, where free plants might be found in public places. So for example, I have an outdoor shopping mall that has a ton of ghost succulents like this. It's in a seating planter. People are always sitting on these things. They drop leaves like crazy. I pick up those broken leaves, I bring them home, I propagate them. This entire planter here is just from plants that came from that planter. Now, this does have a caveat. I'm not actively breaking plants. I'm not going into a shopping mall with scissors and clipping plants. I'm simply finding plants that have been broken. I have found snake plants. I have found succulents. I have found purple hearts. There are so many shopping mall plants that get broken that I take home when they're already broken. In a lot of these places, I have asked the owners of the stores nearby if they mind, and they don't. Again, I am not purposely breaking things. I am simply taking things that are already broken, already on the ground, would otherwise have been cleaned up by the landscaping crew and thrown away. I also try and be really active in my neighborhood, taking walks, looking at the curb, seeing if people have left out plants. I check and see in public parks, are there anything that has been broken? Again, something that is already broken and would otherwise have been cleaned up and thrown away. Where I live, a lot of neighbors put boxes out full of cuttings, full of free plants, happy for people to take them. So I'm always looking, even when I'm driving a car in other neighborhoods, my family always laughs because I will like stop the car immediately, pull in, and see what free plants people have left out. I have gotten so many free plants that way. I found giant agave blue flames that way where they had just gotten overgrown and people threw them onto the curb. There was a free sign. I also walk around my neighborhood on garbage day. We have green bins, which means any tree cuttings or yard cuttings go into these green bins. I have gotten some great plants that way. This is a little bit like dumpster diving in your own neighborhood, I suppose, but it has gotten me so many free plants. I've gotten a ton of rubber plants. I have gotten pelargonium. There's so many plants that I've gotten that way. And I know for a fact they were just literally going to go into the trash compactor. So walking around in public places, making sure you're taking things that are already cut, which are definitely meant for the bin, and not actively cutting things from people's yard, that is a big no-no. Definitely not cutting landscaping in public places. Again, that's a big no-no. But taking things that have already been broken or cut and repropagating them, flowers that have maybe gone to seed, you will take the little seed heads, that's absolutely acceptable. And finally, my number one place to get free plants, and this is the controversial one that you all argue about in the comments, garden centers. Now, I have a whole video dedicated to me going to Home Depot, walking around, finding broken leaves on the ground, where in the video you can see they are broken, they are on the ground, I am not breaking things. They're all very small pieces of plants that would otherwise end up in the bin at Home Depot and bringing them home. Now, the controversy here, some people think this is stealing. I think it all depends on the context, right? I'm not breaking things. I'm not taking things that would otherwise have been regrown. These are all things that would otherwise be swept up and put in the trash. So a good example of this is if you're doing this at a family nursery, a lot of times if there's a broken plant, they will regrow that, and that is a big no-no. Unless, and this goes for Home Depot, Lowe's, Walmart, wherever you are, you can ask. Ask. If you find a leaf like this on the ground at Home Depot, ask the staff, hey, do you mind if I have this leaf? More likely than not, they'll say fine. One other thing I should say about this is I go to Home Depot a lot. I spend a lot of money there. When I'm in the checkout, usually if I'm buying something, sometimes I'll like put the little broken piece of plant in the pot that I'm purchasing, so it's very clear that it's there. Sometimes I'll mention it, sometimes I won't. I've never had any issues. Places like Home Depot, they usually buy their plants from vendors. Home Depot aren't taking those cuttings and reselling them. The vendors aren't coming back and picking up broken leaves off the ground and replanting them. That's not happening. Anything that is already broken is more likely than not going to end up in the trash. And so that's the kind of thing we're talking about here. We're not talking about ruining stock that would otherwise have been sold. We're not talking about cutting things. We're simply only looking to the stuff that is on the ground. The reason this is a gray area in other family-owned businesses is, yes, sometimes they will take those leaves and regrow them because they're a small business and that's part of their business plan. That said, if you strike up a relationship, if you talk to the owners, make a rapport, get to know them, like be a good customer, do buy things, a lot of times they will gift you stuff. So for example, this little peanut cactus, we have a local farmer's market. There's a guy there that has a stand there with some absolutely beautiful plants. He has a local greenhouse. You can't visit the greenhouse. You can only buy his stuff at the farmer's market. I have a 5-year-old daughter who is absolutely admiring this plant. He grabbed one piece, handed it to her, told her to put it in soil. It's grown a whole new plant. I did end up buying a big plant from him. Again, similar to like the plant swap friends and family, you know, it's all about people with a mutual love of plants. And for him as a business owner, you know, it's great to like have great rapport with his customers. The piece was already broken off. He was happy to give it to us. He knows we're gonna come back. And also I'm gonna give this shout out to him, Santa Barbara Farmers Market. Go visit his stand. He is amazing. He has absolutely beautiful plants. He sells fiddle leaf figs at rock bottom prices. I don't know his name. I should actually ask his name next time. But that is an absolutely acceptable way to get free plants. Talk to the people, ask. So from plant sellers, whether you are Proplifting, AKA picking up leaves off the ground, asking for them, or making friends with people that own plant stores and plant shops, it's all a great way to get free plants. In saying all of this, I have got most of my plant collection for really, really cheap, if not completely free. And I started this channel so I could share all my free plant tips and tricks for you. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me. I might do a tour of all of my free plants. I have tons of videos showing my garden. I have a lot of videos showing how I propagated my plants that came from cuttings or came for free. If there's any plants you have any questions about or that you'd like to see how to propagate or how to get for free, just let me know in the comments. Don't forget to check me out on TikTok and Instagram, and of course, subscribe. Thank you.